Subscribe to our channel and click on the bell button to receive important financial updates faster than anybody else. Friends, welcome to our channel Profit in Equities. Now, if you like our content, please don't forget to hit the like button. Also, subscribe to our channel and click on the bell button to receive important financial updates at the earliest. Now, IIFL is a financial services conglomerate from India. Here, we talk about 7 stocks which IIFL Wealth Management has highlighted as their preferred place on budget expectations for budget 2018. Now, please don't treat these as blind buys on your part. Please go ahead and conduct your due diligence. Also, please go ahead and consult your financial advisor prior to acting on any of the information that you find here. Also, friends, we are providing the source of the information in the description section below. So please go ahead and go through that article as well. And then you would be able to go ahead and take an informed decision for any investment decision that you want to take. Please watch this video to know more. Now, the first stock on the list and a play on the budget from the defense and electronics sector is Bharat Electronics Limited. Now, this stock is available at 176.90 and the code for it is BEL. Now, Bharat Electronics Limited is engaged in design, manufacture and supply of electronics product systems for the defense requirements as well as for non-defense markets. The company's principal products slash services include weapon systems, radar and fire control systems, and also communication systems. Now, if you were to look at the 1-year chart, you would see that the company has consistently created a lot of wealth for its stakeholders. However, of late, there has been some sort of a fall. The market cap is 43,464.17 crores, which means that the company is a large cap one. The EPS is 6.93, which translates into a price to earnings ratio of 25.53. Now, this is largely in line with the industry PE of 28.52. The book value is 30.56, which translates into a price to book ratio of 5.79. Now, this is a bit on the higher side. The dividend yield percent is 1.27 and the promoter holding here is 66.72, with the promoter being the Government of India. The 52-week high stands at 193.40, whereas the 52-week low for the stock is at 132.36. Now, one factor for the stock is that this stock has been common in most of the brokerage recommendations for 2018 and also some of the preferred ideas where this has been put forward for multi-bagger or budget expectation plays. Now, the second company on the list is Larsen & Toubro Limited, which is available at 1416.50. The code for it is LT. Now, Larsen & Toubro Limited is a technology, engineering, construction, manufacturing and financial services company. Now, if you were to look at the near chart for the stock, you would see that the stock rose for the initial part of the year and for the latter part of the year. But towards the middle of the year, there was a good amount of consolidation as far as the stock price was concerned. The market cap is 1,98,456.13 crores, which means that the company is a large cap one. The EPS is 27.90. which translates into a price to earnings ratio of 50.77, which is very expensive. The industry PE here is 24.02, whereas the book value is 290.53, translating into a price to book ratio of 4.88. Now, the factor here to remember is that this company is probably the best in its sector, and hence, even though it's expensive, but we must compare it with respect to the quality which this company has. The debt to equity is 2.1253, and here it's imperative to mention that this sector has companies which are highly leveraged, and so this seems to be still okay. The return on equity is 0.1383, whereas the dividend yield is 1.48%. The 52-week high for the stock stands at 1427.05, whereas the 52-week low is 921.31. Now, this stock was also recommended by Citigroup as part of the list of stocks which it has highlighted as part of the preferred plays on the budget expectations. Now, the third company on the list is Bharat Forge Limited, which is available at 721.15. The code for the company is BHARATFORG. Now, Bharat Forge Limited is engaged in the business of steel forgings, finished machined crankshafts and front axles assembly and components. Now, the segments for this company include forgings and projects. Now, if you were to look at the one-year chart, you would see that the company has been on a consistent uptrend with a beautiful peak and troughs progression. The market cap of the company is 33,575.92 crores, which means that the company is a large cap one. The EPS is 15.36, which translates into a price to earnings ratio of 46.95, which is below the industry PE of 68.06. Now, the book value is 90.89, which translates into an expensive price to book ratio of 7.93. The dividend yield is 1.04. Now, the promoter holding here is on the lower side at 45.75. The 52-week high is 756, whereas the 52-week low is 457.50. Now, among the auto ancillary stocks, this is a stock having the highest pedigree, and hence, we must keep a close watch on the movement going forward. Now, the fourth stock on the list is Siemens Limited, and Siemens Limited is available at 1296.10. The code for the company is SIEMENS. Now, Siemens Limited is a holding company engaged in the manufacturing of electric motors, generators, transformers, and electricity distribution, control apparatus, general purpose machinery, and electrical signaling, safety, or traffic control equipment. Now, if you were to look at the one-year chart for the stock, you would see that the company was literally all over the place. It rose for the initial part of the year, but since then it was on a downtrend, but of late there has been a rise again. The market cap is 46,156.75 crores, which means that the company is a large cap one. The EPS is 31.81, which translates into a price to earnings ratio of 40.75. The industry PE is 47.45 and is a little more expensive compared to the company's PE. The book value is 216.35, which translates into a price to book ratio of 5.99, which is much on the higher side. The company is debt free and hence the debt to equity ratio is 0. The return on equity is 0.1435. The dividend yield percent is 0.54, whereas the promoter holding here is 75 and is pretty good. The 52-week high stands at 1471.35, whereas the 52-week low for the stock stands at 1119.45. Now, this company is a play on the capital goods sector. The fifth company on the list is KEC International Limited, which is available at 364.30. The code for the company is KEC. Now, KEC International Limited is engaged in the construction of utility projects. Its geographical segments includes India and outside India. Its power transmission and distribution business includes providing end-to-end solutions in power transmission and distribution. Its cable service offerings includes extra high voltage EHV cabling solutions provided through cables selection and cabling system and manufacturing of a range of power, which is high tension and EHV cables, control, telecommunication and instrumentation cables. Now, if you were to look at the one-year chart, again, it's a beautifully uptrending chart and a lot of wealth has also been created here. The market cap is 9365.73 crores, which means that the company is a mid-cap one. The EPS is 13.68, which translates into a price-to-earnings ratio of 26.63, which is more expensive compared to the industry PE of 18.63. The book value is 64.40, which translates into a price-to-book ratio of 5.66. The debt to equity is 1.6618, whereas the return on equity is 0.2228. Now, if you were to look at the dividend yield here is 0.44, whereas the promoter holding here is average at 50.94. Now, the 52-week high for the stock stands at 392, whereas the 52-week low is 140. Now, the second last company on the list is Kalpataru Power Transmission Limited, which is available at 471.70. Now, Kalpataru Power Transmission Limited is an engineering, procurement and construction company, and the company manufactures metal frameworks or skeletons for construction and parts such as towers, masts, trusses and bridges. Its segment include transmission and distribution, infrastructure EPC and others. The code for the company is KALPATPOWR. Now, if you were to look at the one-year chart, you would see that the company has been on a consistent uptrend for the entire year, and a lot of wealth creation has happened here. The market cap is 7238.74 crores, which means that the company is a mid-cap one. The EPS is 18.81, which translates into a price-to-earnings ratio of 25.08. Now, this is again expensive compared to the industry PE of 18.63. The book value is 161.50, which translates into a price-to-book ratio of 2.92. The dividend yield is a bit low here at 0.42, whereas the promoter holding here is average at 59.32. The 52-week high for the stock stands at 535, whereas the 52-week low for the stock stands at 261.65. Now, with government's increased focus on trying to electrify villages, trying to improve capex, and trying to support the capital goods sector, this stock could go ahead and do very well from here. Now, the final company on the list is ABB India Limited, which is available at 1659.30. The code for the company is ABB. Now, ABB India Limited is an India-based company which is engaged in power and automation business. Now, if you were to look at the one-year chart, you would see that the stock rose for the initial part of the year, but then underwent a severe consolidation, and of late, it has been rising again. Now, the pattern may also resemble sort of a rounding bottom formation, if you were to look at it technically. The market cap is 35,161.96 crores, which means that the company is a large cap one. The EPS is 18.65, which translates into a very expensive price to earnings ratio of 88.97. Now, one factor to note here is that the industry PE also is very high at 61.36, and hence this company is not alone in being expensive from this sector. The book value is 154.92, which translates into a very expensive price to book ratio of 10.71. The dividend yield here is on the lower side at 0.24, and the promoter holding here is good at 75. The 52-week high for the stock stands at 1687, whereas the 52-week low for the company stands at 1046.45. Now, friends, this information came out in one of the leading portals, and we'll be sharing the link in the description below. Also, please don't go for the habit of blindly following what anybody tells you. So that should apply to us as well. Please go ahead and do your own research. Also, conduct your own due diligence. Consult your financial advisor prior to acting on any of the information that you ever see on this channel. Thanks for watching, and we will see you soon with another video.